I will briefly discuss the steps for POP cast application, as there are four steps. Number one is recognition. Identify the bone. If you identify the bone, it will be helpful, because in the cast application you have to immobilize one joint above and one joint below. Let's say the fracture is here, so you have to immobilize this joint and you have to immobilize this joint also. Okay, so you have to immobilize one joint above and one joint below. Second is reduction. For good reduction, please give sedation to the animals, as it is not a very good practice to reduce the fracture without sedation, because number one, it will cause pain, and the number two reason that is very important is that after you give sedation, there will be muscle relaxation and that will lead to good fracture reduction. So please give sedative before you reduce the fracture fragments. After giving sedation, position the animal, keeping the affected limb upwards. Then you can apply traction and counter-traction, which will help in reduction of the fracture fragments. And the third step is retention. For the retention, first of all, position the animal and then apply any hygroscopic powder like boric acid or zinc oxide powder. After that, do the padding. The padding is very important. If you are not doing the good padding, then it will lead to POP by wound, and if you are doing excessive padding, that may lead to loose cast. Okay, so you have to do padding and bandaging. Afterwards, you have to apply splint if required. Then you have to dip the POP cast in lukewarm water and apply it. And the most important thing is drying. Drying in case of POP cast, because it takes a long time. Although the drying time depends upon the temperature of the area in which you are doing the procedure, and it also depends upon the quality of the cast bandage available with you, but still it's my advice if you can keep it more than 20 to 25 minutes, because there are very, it's a very problematic thing that you apply the cast and after one to think the animal days the animal come that owner says the fracture has POP cast has been broken, but you have done. So please allow it to dry properly. And the other thing is, you have to dip the POP bandage till the bubbles come out. Okay. And the fourth point is rehabilitation. Rehabilitation is very important in cast application, because all the joints are immobilized. So you have to mobilize the joint after the cast removal by exercise and physiotherapy. This slide shows the application of fibrocast application. It is almost similar to POP, but there are certain differences, like the cast is to be dipped in simple water, while in POP you are dipping it in the lukewarm water. So this can be dipped in simple water, so no need to for lukewarm water here. And then you have to dry. The drying time here is 3 to 5 minutes, so if you apply the cast, wait for 5 minutes only and then allow the animal to stand. So it is very fast procedure. The two differences were, you have to dip in water for few seconds only. And important thing is, we have to wear the gloves while we apply the fiberglass cast, because otherwise this fiberglass will adhere to your hands for weeks and it's very bad. So please wear gloves before you apply the fiberglass cast. This case was treated at TVCC Navsari. This is a buffalo calf. Applied with POP, a splint was used. This is splint plus POP casting. This again was treated at PCC Navsari. Here, this buffalo calf was treated by fiberglass bandage and no splint was applied, and it gave very good result. The fracture fixation was very good, and you can see the immediate weight bearing. So there are certain important points for the cast application. Let's start the application of cast from one end. I have seen many people, they start from center. It is a bad practice. You either start from proximal end or distal end, and preferably distal end is good. And then full limb casting is recommended. So many a times you leave the paw and there are chances of swelling in that. So you apply full limb cast from proximal end till the end. Another important point is, each turn of the cast should overlap the preceding turn by 1/3 or 1/2 of the width. Okay, and the other important point is that I have already discussed, the drying is very important, otherwise the cast may break. as the hardening time of POP is longer, you have to take care in case of this thing. Then regular monitoring is very important. If possible, you can take the radiographs. Otherwise, it can take 45 to 60 days for the fracture to heal. The post-application cast should remain dry. Again, this there is a problem in POP because it is having hygroscopic nature. So it may take the water and that may lead to go to the skin. There will be smell and that is not good. There will be discharge, smell, swelling. So if that happens, you have to remove the cast immediately. Okay. Another thing is that this is very useful in case of the simple fracture, I mean closed fracture. If the fracture is open, this cast application is not very much advisable. Even if you are doing it, go for the window cast, and if not possible, use another fixation method. This is the picture of a calf treated with window casting. The fiberglass bandage was applied. Here you can see this elevation. A cap of a bottle was kept below the bandage, and after the cast application, it was cut. And this was the appearance. There was a big wound present here, and this wound healed after around, this was around 7 to 8 days after that fracture casting was applied. The window has to be made according to the size of the wound. But if the wound is very large or multiple wounds are present, it may weaken the cast and cast may break. So in case of multiple wounds, please do not apply the cast. Go for another or other fixation methods. Here the slide is showing the hanging pin cast. This image I have taken from the internet. Hanging pin cast is mostly useful for the fracture of tibia of the large ruminants. If the animal is small like calf or dog or cat or goat, sheep, then we can apply cast in case of tibia. But in case of heavier animals, the cast is not staying here. It will come out as a hole. So to hold that, pass a pin through the tibia. First cross this pin and then you can apply the cast. There are chances that it will remain here, otherwise this will come out, and for tibia fracture, the cast application is not advised unless you do this cross pinning of this hanging pin cast. So this slide shows the effect of number of layers on the cast. This red one is the POP and this blue one is the fiberglass. You can see in this graph, as the number of layer increases, the weight of the cast also increases. And as the weight increases, the bulkiness of cast also increases. And this increase is more in case of the POP. So please, if you are increasing the number of layers, this POP will hamper the movement of the animal, as this is heavier and this is not a good characteristic of any fixation. It should be as lightweight as possible. So go for the fiberglass fixation. Up to 8 layers also, you can see the weight of fiberglass is significantly lower than this POP cast. Then this graph, it shows the biomechanical characters of the fiberglass and POP. As you can see, the load bearing capacity of POP is significantly lower than that of fiberglass. And as you increase the number of layers, even one layer increases the load bearing capacity significantly. But this increase is not so significant for POP. So if you use POP, you have to add so many layers and it will again increase the bulkiness. But if you use fiberglass, it will improve the biomechanical properties significantly even by one layer. So in case of heavy animal, this fiberglass bandage is very, very useful, as the mechanical properties of fiberglass bandage are better than that of the POP. This table shows the comparison of physical properties of POP as well as fiberglass. The POP application is comparatively messy as compared to fiberglass. The time of application is more because we need to put splint in that. Time of hardening is also more in case of POP. It is more hygroscopic, it is bulkier, and the mechanical strength is less. Still, the POP is mostly used in case of the field because there are two things. The number one is availability. All the fiberglass is also available nowadays in the field. And the number two is that the cost. POP is very, very cheaper as compared to fiberglass. But if you can consult the shopkeeper, he will give you on the subsidized rate this fiberglass paint, as it is having very good mechanical properties. So in the field condition, if you give fiberglass paintage, it will improve the results significantly, and it will be very helpful for the animal as well as for the veterinarian. Coming to the second fixation technique, which can be used in the field, that is external skeletal fixation. External skeletal fixators have been divided into fixed frame and free frame. The fixed frame ESF are like this. These are made up of the metal. The frame is fixed and the direction and the number of pins cannot be changed. Whereas the second form is free form, like this. Let us suppose this is bone and this is the fixator applied. The number of pins can be changed and the direction of pin can also be changed. That is why it is called the free form. What are the advantages of the external skeletal fixator that we are discussing it here? It is minimally invasive method. There are no implant in the fracture site. Here you can see, this is the fracture site. There is no implant here. Implants are above and below the fracture site. So it will not interfere with the hematoma, the natural hematoma, and it will not interfere with the fracture healing. There is immediate weight bearing after the surgery. It maintains normal joint mobility. It is one advantage external fixator, skeletal fixator have over the external competition, because in that the joints were immobilized. And also it can be used in case of open fractures also. The casts were difficult to apply in the open fracture because of certain disadvantages, but these can be applied in case of open fractures also, because wound management in open fractures is very good by the external skeletal fixators. And the free form required the minimal instrumentation. We will discuss it further. This fixed frame, that is the metallic one, they have been divided into linear, circular, and hybrid depending upon the shape. I will give only broad classification. I will not go into the deeper classification. And the instrumentation which is required for this ESF. For linear ESF, you need fixation pins, you need linkage bolts, you need external connecting bars. And for ELISA rod, that is the circular fixator, you need rings, wires, connectors, and rods. And in addition, you need a drill machine. What is the main disadvantage associated with them is that they are not easily available in the field conditions. So their use is not, they are not very much used. Another thing is free form of ESF, which have already been used by above 100 to 120 kg animals, and they are very easy to fabricate or engineer in the field conditions also. So they are very useful, and we will discuss about these two type of ESF only, because they are very useful in case of the field condition. Number one is the acrylic type and number two is the epoxy type. The instrumentation which is required for free form of fixator is minimal. You need only K wires, you need a K wire bender, you need a drill machine. Any drill machine which is available at the hardware stores, it may cost around 1000 to 2000. They can be used in case of the free form of fixator application. Then epoxy resin like MC laser, freely available in the market in all the shops, in all the hardware shops. It can be used if we are preparing this epoxy pin ESF. And this acrylic type of ESF requires the dental acrylic. It is most common acrylic which are used for the dental with the dental surgeons. And then this is PVC pipe. This is most commonly used in washing machine. This is washing machine pipe, PVC pipe. This can be used for the acrylic type of fixator. So, as far as metallic, this fixed frame and free form are concerned, the free form are better because they are polymeric material. They have better availability, comparatively cheaper, and also light in weight, because these ones are metallic, so they are heavier. And in the field condition, the use of free form is better because the direction and size of the pin can be changed according to the type of fracture, according to the size of the animal. Whereas the fixed frame, they are coming in a fixed frame and you have to apply that frame only. Okay. This is the brief procedure of the application of the free form of etc. We have to pass the pains by introducing the pains through the soft tissue up to the level of bone. The first pain is to be passed in the smaller fragment, then alternatively in the bigger, and then smaller, and then bigger fragment. And they, while passing it, keep it as perpendicular as possible and cross the pins at the angle of 70 to 90 degree. Let us understand this thing with the help of these models. Let us suppose this is a bone. I am showing you acrylic type of ESF etc. construction. Let us suppose this is a bone. First of all, you have to drill through the bone. Here you can see the pins are crossing each other, but they are a little up and down, because if they are passed in the same plane, they will cross each other inside the bone. So please take care that they should not cross each other inside the bone. Okay, so first of all, you have to drill the K wires, or I am calling it pins, through the bone. And then after this scaffold is formed, you put this PVC tubing. This PVC tubing is to be put inside the fixation pins, and this will form a temporary scaffold. And in this temporary scaffold, from this point, this is open. You have to put the liquid acrylic in that. You have to take care that do not overfill it, because it will expand after it is filled. So it may come out. So you have to fill it, and then after it is hardened, you seal the ends of the pipe. Okay. One precaution that you have to take is that it is highly exothermic in nature, and there is a lot of heat generated while you pour the acrylic for the hardening. So you have to put in between cold water, or you have to put this crushed ice in between the connecting bar and the skin. Otherwise, thermal injury will happen to the body. Let us understand the different type of structures which can be made with the help of acrylic ESF. These are the four models available which can be fabricated easily. This one is uniplanar. See, if this is the bone, the pins are passed in one plane. So this is uniplanar. Three pins are passed in the proximal segment, three pins are passed in the distal segment. And these are connected through the connecting rods, which are prepared with the help of acrylic. It can be made multiplanar. Here you see it is passed in variable planes. So this is multiplanar one. This is multiplanar two. Multiplanar two has, these two are joined here. These two connecting bars are joined here, and it becomes the multiplanar two. What is the what are the advantage that we are joining these two? There are advantages that if you connect the bar, it will increase the mechanical strength significantly. So we are joining these two connecting bar in case of multiplanar two. And if you see here in the circular, all the connecting bars have been joined. So this is the strongest of all the models. The circular one is strongest, but multiplanar two is also very strong, and in the field you can use any of these three: multiplanar one, multiplanar two, and circular. Uniplanar is not very strong, so I will not recommend its use. You can use multiplanar one, multiplanar two, and circular type of model of acrylic in the field condition. And here you can see this is multiplanar type 2, which is applied on the limb of the animal. These are some of the radiographs of animals treated with acrylic. This work was done at IVRI. This is the preoperative photograph. This is postoperative, and this is the follow-up. Here you can see the callus formation. These are the animals treated with the acrylic type of ESF. This is multiplanar type 1 design, and these two are treated with multiplanar 2. And you can see there is some change in shape. So that is a good thing, because you can change the shape and direction according to the requirement of the animal. Coming to the second, which is very useful, is epoxy pin ESF. Here I'll describe the procedure again. Let us suppose it is bone, and you have drilled the K wires through the bone. After that, you have to bend the K wires. See here, the K wires are bent over here. after they are bent, that they will be joined like this. This is the proximal fragment, this is the distal fragment, and these K wires are joined to form a temporary scaffold. After this temporary scaffold is formed, you have to mix the MCL. Anyone who has used this MCL can know there are two things available in the pack. You have to mix them together to make a uniform colored dough. After a uniform colored dough is formed, apply it on the scaffold which is formed. Here you can see, this is the scaffold formed. And let me explain with the help of models the four designs which can be made. First one is uniplanar. The pins are passed in one plane and these are the connecting bar. The connecting bar can be, are generally which we are using 20 mm. This is multiplanar, multiplanar type 1. This is multiplanar type 2, as this is shown in this case also. We have used multiplanar type 2 and this is circular. So in this model, as we increase the complexity of the design, you come from uniplanar to multiplanar, multiplanar 1 to 2, and then from to circular, the mechanical properties of the fixator increase. That is the load bearing capacity, the stiffness, all increase as the complexity of these designs increases. So these can be used in animals up to 100 to 120 kg, all the dogs, all the goat, sheep, calf and foal, they can be treated with the help of these type of fixators. This is a case which was treated at BCC Navsari. After patient positioning, the pins were passed. After the pins were passed, they were bent together and tied to form a temporary scaffold. And this scaffold was then applied with the MCL, the epoxy. Any epoxy can be used. We had used MCL in this case. And these connecting bars were further joined up and down while multiplier type 2 of design. Now coming to the fixator removal. The fixator removal is also very easy. You do not need any special instrument for that. You need only a pin cutter. This is a plier easily available in all the households. Cut the pin from one direction and pull it off from the other direction. And if it is not coming, you can cut from here also, cut from both the direction. And this is the appearance of the limb after the fixator is removed. See, only small holes are present here, and these are the pin tracks. So after the fixator has been removed, the pin track are to be dressed minimum for 10 to 15 days so that the healing occurs and there is no infection in that. These are the images of cases treated at IVRI. This is pre-operative, this is post-operative, and this is the follow-up x-ray of a case treated by epoxy. These are the images of epoxy and acrylic. This is a gross photograph of dog which are showing very good weight bearing after the cases were treated with epoxy ESF. And these cases were done by my guide, Dr. Ethel. I have worked under his leadership and he is a very good person. He had taught me how to apply this, and he's using them very long in open fractures and closed fractures also. This was applied on a calf. It was around 100 kg, and in foal also you can see very good weight bearing. Some important points which has to be kept in mind while applying this ESF is that you have to use a very low speed electricity. Do not go for high speed because it may lead to thermal necrosis and the pin may wobble. Also, the second point is that the pins should not interfere with each other in the medullary cavity. As already discussed, you can see here, you can keep it slightly up and down so that they do not cross at each other. If they cross in the medullary cavity, the pin will not come out of the other end. Another very important thing is that continuously drop cold, sterile, normal saline solution while drilling. While you drill, as already I have shown in one photograph also, while we drill the bone, continuously pour on the normal saline or some water on it, if preferably cold, because while drilling there is generation of heat which can lead to thermal necrosis. And to prevent that, please add this cold sterile solution continuously while drilling. It will reduce the side effects of the drilling inside the bone. After the applicator has been applied, fixator has been applied, regular monitoring is required, and if possible, take the radiographs. Post application, we have to do regular antiseptic dressing at the entry and exit point of the pains. All the points here, these points, all are to be dressed at least twice daily till the fixator is removed. You have to dress them because they will be discharged from all these points. If some movement is noticed, what will you will do? If some type of movement is noticed, you can do one thing. You can add some connecting bars in between. Like in multiplanar, if some movement is noticed, you can add connecting bar, and that will significantly increase the stability of the fixator. The good thing about fixators is that they can be used in simple as well as in compound fractures. So this is acrylic, which I have discussed, and this is epoxy. They too also have some limitations and advantages and disadvantages. In case of acrylic, while you mix it, there is a formation of noxious and irritant fumes. So you have to wear the mask and gloves every time you use the acrylic for the formation of the ESF. It is in the liquid state, which is slightly difficult to handle. And there are possible of leakages from the pin to pipe point. And it is very exothermic reaction. As already discussed, you have to put cold water or crushed ice. The hardening time is very less. It will harden within 3 to 5 minutes. The weight is very less. It is very lightweight and it is a very good character. Relative cost is more when we compare it with the epoxy. And radiographically, as already seen, this is translucent. Whereas epoxy, while using epoxy, there is no formation of heat or no fumes are formed. It is dirty in consistency and easy to handle. The only problem is that radiographically it is opaque. So while you are doing fixation with epoxy ESF, take minimum of 2 radiographs in orthogonal view so that the bone can be seen, because it will hamper the radiographic evaluation of the fracture healing. Now there are certain thumb rules which are to be remembered while you are applying the fixator. First is pin number. The more numbers you put inside the fracture fragments, the stabler will be the fixation. Like in these 2 diagrams, you can see this is 2-point fixation per segment, 1 and 2 per segment. And this shows 3-point fixation per segment. This 3-point fixation is stiffer than this 2-point fixation. So this will be more stable. And the thumb rule says you should have minimum of 3 pins per segment, or overall 6 pins. Second is pin size. The pin size you have, pin size stiffness is directly proportional to 4th power of pin diameter. But it doesn't mean you can take a largest pin. The pin number should not exceed 20 to 30% of the bone diameter. For example, a bone is having 6 mm diameter. So 20% will be 1.2, 30% will be 1.8. So for a bone of 6 mm diameter, the pin or K wire should be between 1.2 to 1.8, and 1.5 mm pin is most commonly used for such type of bones. Coming to the pin length, the shorter pin is stiffer and the longer pin will have less stability. Because stiffness is inversely proportional, means ulta. Stiffness is inversely proportional to the 3rd power of the pin length. But you should also take care that while you apply the fixator, there will be certain swelling, inflammatory changes at the entry point of the pins. So you have to keep a minimum distance of 2 cm. Keep a minimum of 2 cm distance for any soft tissue swelling which is expected between the skin and the side bars. Then is the pin location. Far near, near far principle is used, and there should be no implant at the fracture site. Please keep it in the mind while passing the ESF. There should be no pin placement at here. There should be no pin placed in between the 2 fractured segments. And then pin placement, as already discussed, drilling is between 200 to 300 RPM. Do not go the speeds higher than that. Only connect to drilling between 200 to 300 RPM speed. So after which I have discussed the fixation techniques which can be used in the field. Here is the summary. A dog comes to you and you have to do any fixation. Then is TCR, which is to be given under field condition for any type of fixation in dogs, either go for sedation or general anesthesia. And if forelimb fracture is there and humor is involved, there will be internal skeletal fixation. So it can be referred to some polyclinic. And if the fracture is below the elbow and it is closed, you can apply Thomas splint or you can type any type of fiberglass or POP cast, or you can apply ESF. If the fracture is open, then please don't do further casting. You can apply ESF. For the hind limb, again, femur, we can use internal skeletal fixation. Again, it has to be referred. Then for tibia, you can apply cast, you can apply ESF. ISF also can be used in tibia. And then below the stifle, if it is closed, apply Thomas splint, cast or ESF. And if it's open, you can go for external skeletal fixation. For small ruminants and calves, if small ruminants have been presented in the field conditions to you, then for all the surgeries, orthopedic surgeries, you can give sedation with local analgesia. In forelimb, you can use the brachial plexus nerve block, or you can go for IVRA, intravenous regional anesthesia. In hind limb, you can use anterior epidural anesthesia, or you can go for IVRA. And in addition, you can go for local infiltration analgesia. Below the elbow, for closed fracture, again, you can use Thomas splint cast, POP or fiberglass, or you can apply ESF. And for open fractures, ESF can be used. For hind limb, again, for the tibia, here you can apply the cast. If the ruminant is there, small ruminants, sheep, goat, and calves, you can apply the cast. And below the stifle, you can use Thomas splint and ESF or cast. And for open, you can go for ESF application. For the large ruminants, if there is forelimb, for the closed fracture below the elbow, you can go for splinting, cast application, and ESF. And for open fracture, you can go for ESF, window cast, or splinting. For hind limb, for tibia, especially this, you can see this tibia, as there is excessive muscle mass and it is in close proximity to the body, the cast will not stay here. So as already described, you can pass a pin from here and then you can go for hanging pin cast in case of tibia in large ruminants. Otherwise, below the hock, you can go for cast application, ESF application, and if it's open, you can go for window casting, you can go for splinting, gutter splints, or you can apply external skeletal fixator. But for external skeletal fixator, only metallic can be used in large heavyweight ruminants. Small ruminants can use the polymeric type of ESF. For heavyweight ruminants, you cannot use polymeric type of ESF. You need metallic type of ESF for these, and which are not easily available in the field conditions. So this summarizes my presentation. I have told briefly about the anesthesia and the most common techniques which can be used in the field conditions. For any veterinarian, you should not leave the case. Please do the cases, apply fixator, you can apply cast, whatever available with you. And if you are not able to do, please refer the cases. Do not delay the cases, as the delayed presentation leads to the complication in the cases. And this is all from my side. Thank you very much. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you.
Thank you, madam, for your nice presentation. Now we are go forward for the question and answer session. I will check the question. Madam, the question from K.V. Nagar. If the swelling is seen with POP cast, then we have removed it. Then what further step have to be taken?
Hello.
Yes, madam. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Sir, the question is, this swelling is seen with the POP cast. Yes. As I have already discussed, if you are applying the POP cast or any cast, go for full limb split casting. You should apply the cast from front, from proximal to distal end, involving the whole length of the limb. Then there are least chances of swelling. And still, if you are finding any type of swelling or smell, then remove it immediately, allow the swelling to subside. You can splint bandage it for 1-2 days, and then again you can apply the cast after the swelling has been reduced. Immediately do not apply the cast after the cast has been removed, because it, the swelling will take time to subside.
Thank you, madam. The another question from Dr. Mallory. What material or metal is recommended for thymus splint in large animals?
For large animals, actually aluminium bars are not very much useful. The thymus splint is also to be fabricated for that. Generally, iron rods are taken, and the ring is prepared separately, and the rods are welded with that, and then the thymus splint is fabricated, and then it is applied. So you will be using this iron for the application of thymus splint in case of the large heavy animals. But otherwise, for the lightweight, you can use aluminium, and you can double the aluminium rods also.
Thank you, madam. Another question from Dr. Manjusha. What is the position of placing splint in the forelimb and hind limb, like cranial or caudal, to the bone?
Excuse me, sir.
Position of placing splint in the forelimb and hind limb.
The position of placing splints is that you have to put in the tension side. Generally, we are putting medial lateral splints in all the forelimb and hind limb. But the direction can be changed according to the wound. If there is wound, then the splint is not put on that. Otherwise, medial lateral splinting is used.
Can you tell me, madam, something about hanging pin cast?
Hanging pin cast, as I have already discussed, these hanging type of pin cast, they are used only for the tibia in case of heavyweight animals. If the animal weight is less, and as I have told you that in casting you need to stabilize one joint above and one joint below. For the tibia, we need stifle joint above and hock joint below. Hock joint is easily available in case of heavyweight ruminants. But for the stifle joint, the muscle mass is too much there, and it is very attached to the body. So that joint is not, we cannot fix that joint very easily. And even if we fix that joint, that cast will come out as such, whole cast will come out. So for allowing that cast to stay at the place, we pass a pin in the tibia. That pin is passed like external skeletal fixator through and through. It is passed from the skin. It will reach one cortex, then another cortex, and then it will come through out of the skin. So it will be percutaneous pin. So that first that pin will be passed, and after that apply the cast. So that will help in holding the cast. Otherwise, the hanging pin has no function of itself. It will only help to hold the cast that is applied on the tibia.
Thank you, madam. Another question from Dr. Krunal Patel. Any immobilization technique available for spinal fracture in dogs?
Immobilization for spinal fractures, actually direct immobilization is not available. You can go for the splinting. The spinal splints are available in the market. That will reduce the movement of the spine. You can go for the spinal splinting, or spinal surgery you can go. Spinal surgery, but it's not very successful. But only splints are available in the market, and you can stabilize the spine based on the area of spine involved. Use the spinal splint, and they have to be wrapped around the whole abdomen.
Thank you, madam. Another question from Dr. Mallory. This transtibial pin, should it be applied anterior or posterior of site of fracture on tibia?
Let me show the photograph. See, you can see here, this is passed from cranial and to caudal. You can say anterior posteriorly. From here, it is passed to here. It is passed from anterior to posteriorly, and then the cast is applied.
Thank you, madam. There is a lots of good comment. I would like to share one. Dr. Mallory, She told that, madam, can you please give another seminar, especially for fracture of femur and humerus? Thank you.
It depends upon LMU platform. If they allow me, I'll
thank definitely, you. Definitely, madam. Definitely. We will invite you. Okay, at the end of session, I would like to thank Dr. Surbhi Tyagi for giving the opportunity to us to present our in the NAU platform. I also thank to Dean of the College, Veterinary College, Meerut, and the Vice Chancellor of the Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel University of Agriculture and Technology, Meerut, for allow Dr. Surbhi Tyagi to present over here in this webinar. I would also like to thank our Vice Chancellor, Navsari Agricultural University, and the Dean of the College, Dr. V.B. Kharadi sir, and also the team of the Information and Technology, Navsari Agricultural University. And a special thanks to organizing secretary of this webinar series, Dr. Deepak Suthar, to successfully completion of this seminar. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, participants. Dear participants, the next webinar on will be on next Sunday on same time, 10:30 to 11:30, in NAU webinar series. Thank you.